Good morning children and welcome to the online teaching session. Students, till now we have completed gene, its properties, function and the experiment which proves that DNA is the genetic material. Okay, now today we are starting with the topic structure of DNA. So before we begin the structure, let's see some historical picture of this DNA. Point number one, it is a nucleic acid. Okay, this DNA is a nucleic acid. And this nucleic acid, it was discovered by Frederick Michel, okay, in person. So this nucleic acid was first explained by Frederick Michel in person, and he said that this is acidic in nature. That's why the name is nucleic acid. Okay, now then we come to the name of DNA and the term DNA. Term DNA was given by a scientist named as Zacharias. Clear? So this is the name of the scientist who gave the term DNA. Now, one more point. The structure of the DNA, that is double helical, double helix structure of DNA was discovered by, you all know the name, this we have already read in class 10, the name was given by Watson and Crick. Okay, so Watson and Crick has given the double helical model of DNA, the double helical structure of the DNA. Clear? So these are few points, point number 2, 3 and 4, that explained the historical background or historical picture of the DNA. Now children, this DNA is a polymer of nucleotide, polymer of nucleotide, that's why we call this DNA as a nucleic acid. Okay, so in your class 11th, when you have read the chapter biomolecules, there you must have read about the nucleic acid and nucleotide. There you have seen that this nucleotide, okay, is made up of three things. What are those three things, children? Think and tell. Yes, the three things, I don't know whether you know it or not, but I suppose that you all know this. These three things are pentose sugar, nitrogen base and phosphoric acid. So these three things together form nucleotide, and many nucleotides are called as the polymer of nucleotide, which forms the nucleic acid, which is the structure of the DNA. Okay, so this is the background. Now we will see the structure of the nucleotide. Just have a revision from class 11th. What I told you, that this nucleotide is made up of three things. What are those three things? Pentose sugar. Okay, this is aldose sugar. This you know. Pentose sugar. After this pentose sugar, nitrogen base and phosphoric acid. Okay? Now see, what I told you, this is pentose sugar plus nitrogen base plus phosphoric acid forms one nucleotide. Clear? Now see, if suppose I draw this, now this is your pentose sugar, okay, and the meaning of pentose sugar, four carbons should be in the ring along with one oxygen and fifth one should be at the open side, okay. So now see, this is the oxygen, this is your carbon number 1, carbon number 2, C3, C4 and C5. Clear? At carbon number 1, there will be nitrogen base. Okay, this I am drawing for the pentose sugar. Now see, I have drawn for the pentose sugar. At carbon number 1, there is a nitrogen base. And at carbon number 5, we'll see phosphoric acid. Okay? Now see, at carbon number 2, what we can see, this is the case of deoxyribose nucleic acid. There are two types of pentose sugar, ribose nucleic acid and deoxyribose nucleic acid. If I am talking about deoxyribose, it means at the carbon number 2, on both the sides, there will be hydrogen atom, not the OH functional group. Okay, so what we will see, we'll see that here is also H and this is also H. This is the reason, children, it is called as deoxyribose. Because in case of ribose, see what structure we can find. We can find the structure. Here you will find out C2 along with N2. Here H and OH. Once again, HNOH, here phosphoric acid and this is oxygen. Clear? So, in the pentose sugar, when we will see two functional group, two OH group, it means one oxygen is here. So, now the structure is called as ribose. This I'll explain you once again when we will see the structure of the ribose nucleic acid. So, this is called as the ribose. But here, oxygen is not present. That's why it is called as deoxy. Okay. Now, if we will come to the... Now, I am erasing this C1, C2. It is creating confusion. Because it is now understood that there are carbon. Okay. So, let me draw H and OH. Clear? Now, this is phosphoric acid. Now, see children. This deoxyribose contains only one functional group and ribose nucleic acid contains two functional group, and we all know that the number of functional group increases the rate of reaction of the compound. It makes the compound very active. Okay, if there are two functional group, it means this compound is very reactive. There is only one functional group, it means the compound is almost stable. And this is the reason, children, that out of the RNA and DNA, this DNA is termed as a genetic material. Because it has only one functional group, and because of this functional group, it has become stable. So out of the two, this will be stable, and if this is stable, then only it is treated as the genetic material. And as I told you earlier, that this genetic material, in the field of genetics, everything should be perfect, everything should be stable, and everything should be up to the mark. Not even 0.1 plus and 0.1 minus can be accepted in case of genetics. Okay, so we need a stable compound. And that stable compound is this one because it has only one functional group. Okay. So, this is the structure of deoxyribose, not the complete nucleic acid. This is the structure of one nucleotide. Okay. Nitrogen base. Now, see children. This nitrogen base is connected to the carbon with the help of a bond named as glycosidic bond. Okay, and this phosphoric acid is connected to the carbon number 5 with the help of a bond called as phosphodiester bond. Now we have the two bonds, phosphodiester bond as well as the glycosidic bond. Okay, now nitrogen base, phosphoric acid, one OH group and the complete pentose sugar forms one nucleotide, and many nucleotides combine together to form the polymer which forms the nucleic acid and the structure of the DNA. Now come to the next point, that is nitrogen base. Okay, this also you have read in class 10th only, that we have two types of nitrogen bases. Number one is purine and next one is the pyrimidine. Okay, in case of purine we can see two types of nitrogen bases, and in case of pyrimidine we can see three types of nitrogen bases. Now what are the purines and the pyrimidines? Let me show you. Yes, now see about nitrogen bases. Okay, we have two types of nitrogen bases. One is called purine and next is called pyrimidine. Okay, now purine can be of two type. One is adenine and second is guanine. Clear? And pyrimidine can be of three types, cytosine, thymine and fifth one is uracil. Okay, now see what happens in case of DNA. Out of the purine and pyrimidine, two from the purine and two from the pyrimidine can be joined together. And in case of RNA, out of the purine, the two purines and the out of three pyrimidine, two pyrimidine will join together to form the nitrogen bases of the RNA, and that will be cytosine and uracil. Okay, so in case of RNA, instead of T, we will use uracil. Okay, this again I'll explain you when we'll go to that point. Now, purines and pyrimidines, these are the nitrogen bases. These nitrogen bases are attached to the pentose sugar. Now, how they are attached to the pentose sugar, I'm showing here. This only we have drawn just now. Okay. Now this is our carbon number 1, I can write it here as C1, and this is joined by N2. In case of purines children, carbon 1 means the first position of the carbon. Carbon is equal to first position of the carbon will be joint with the 9th position of nitrogen. Okay, like 1 and 9 binding will take place. 1 and 9 glycosidic bond will be there. 1 and 9. Okay, if you'll see the structure of the purine, then in the purine, the 9th position of the nitrogen will join with the first position of the carbon with the removal of one water molecule. This is the important feature of the glycosidic bond, that the two compound join together, and if they join, then a water molecule will be removed. This is also the part of your biomolecules from class 11. Yes, class 11. So, they all will be joined together by 1 and 9. Okay, now, what happens in case of pyrimidine? In case of pyrimidine, the first position of the carbon will join with first position of nitrogen. Okay, so keep this thing in mind children. In case of purine, 1 and 9 now glycosidic bond, and in case of pyrimidine 1 and 1 glycosidic bond occurs between carbon and the nitrogen bases. Okay, so this is all. Now here again we will see H and H, here H and OH. Let me draw this. Like this I have drawn. This is your N2. Suppose here C1 is there. This HH, HNOH, phosphoric acid. The bond is phosphodiester bond, and this is called as the glycosidic bond. It can be anything in case of purine. It can be A or it can be G. And we have read that A combines with T, C combines with G. So if this is A, then this side it should be T. If this it will be G, then this side it should be C in case of structure of DNA, that is it, deoxyribose nucleic acid. Okay, so this is one nucleotide. Now we can draw many nucleotides to form a polynucleotide. See how we have to draw many nucleotides to form the structure of the DNA. Come, see. Like this. Okay? Oxygen. Now see. N2 C. P H O H H and H. Now we can draw one more. Once again, N2 H and H H N O H and P. One more. N2 H and H O H and P. Now see children, in this way thousands of nucleotides can combine together and then they will form the nucleic acid which will form the structure of the DNA. Now this is the condition of a nucleotide when many nucleotides are there. Now these nucleotides will definitely join together to form the structure. Okay, now how they will join? Because now I have kept them separate. So they are only one nucleotide. But as I told you that it should be the polymer of the nucleotide. So we can say that all these nucleotides should combine with one another. Now how they will combine? You can see from here, that is at carbon number 3, there is a functional group named as OH. And here there is a phosphoric acid. Now this P will join with OH by removal of one water molecule, by the removal of one H2O, and the bond will be called as now phosphodiester bond. So this bond is called as phosphodiester bond. In the same way children, see what happens? With the removal of one water molecule, it will be lost and there will be the bonding, and again this will be called as the phosphodiester bond. Now, see children, from this side, these nucleotides are interconnected with each other and that's why they have formed the structure of polymer of nucleotide. Okay, now this will give the basis of the structure of DNA. After this, when Watson and Crick came forward, then they said that this DNA is a double helical structure. Double helical structure. Okay, that is, if this is one side of the DNA, then there is also one more polymer of nucleotide. Okay, so before we see this structure in detail, we should know some more points related with the structure of the DNA. And these points are like number one, DNA is a polymer of nucleotide. Okay. Now, DNA is a double helical structure. Okay. And these double helical structures are anti-parallel to each other. Okay, this is the second important point. One by one, we will see all the points. Okay, now first point is, okay, that is structure is double helical. It means if this side there is one polymer of nucleotide, then this side also we will see one more polymer of the nucleotide. Okay, and it should be anti-parallel to each other. Anti-parallel to each other. Keep this thing in mind. Now I'll explain you how it is anti-parallel to each other. Now, these two points. Okay. Now, see children. This is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4 and carbon number 5 along with the phosphoric acid. So, this part is free. Clear? This part is free. So, what we can write down here, the fifth carbon, or we can also call it as fifth prime. So we can write down 5 prime or 5 carbon is free here. Okay. 5 carbon is free because there is one phosphoric acid and rest others are in the group. They are forming the pentagonal structure. Now come to the last. Now see, here the fifth carbon is forming something that is phosphodiester bond along with the third carbon. But come here, but this is stable, so there is no any issue. We are not talking about this because C1 is already fixed for the nitrogen. Now which one is free? This OH which is present at the third carbon is free. Okay, so what we can write? We can write down third prime or third carbon is free. Okay, so if I draw this structure like this, then here we can see that 5 prime is free and here 3rd prime is free. Okay, understood why the 5 prime and 3rd prime I have used. 5 prime because this portion is free and 3rd prime means this OH is free. Now, come to the first point given by the Watson and Crick. That is, it is a double helical structure. It means if one side I have drawn this, I am removing, okay, erasing this so that there should not be confusion. I should get the space. Now, it is clear that this is phosphodiester bond and this is the glycosidic bond. Okay. Now, we will draw one more polymer of the nucleotide which should be opposite to this. Because according to him, the second point was, it should be anti-parallel. So, let me draw the anti-parallel, children. Okay. Now, see. I will draw the structure. Let me... The structure will be like this. Oxygen. If this is oxygen, then where should be the carbon number 1? Carbon number 1 will be here. So here we can see nitrogen base. Okay, this is C1, this is C2, C2 contains HNH, C3 will contain HNOH, this is your C4 and this will contain CH2OH, okay, or phosphoric acid, clear? So, here we can see the phosphoric acid. We have to draw one more because we have drawn already 3 nucleotide. So, just draw one more nucleotide, children. See. How to draw? Anti-parallel. According to the rule, it should be anti-parallel. Now, from here, it is clear to you all that what is the meaning of the anti-parallel. Here, HNOH, once again, HNH. This is your nitrogen. Add carbon number 1. And here, we can see phosphoric acid. Okay, add carbon number 5. Draw one more. Draw like this. Clear? See. Carbon number 5, P, then OHNH, then HNH, draw into here. Okay. Now see children, as we have joined here, in the same way we have to join here also, that these phosphoric acid will combine with OH with the help of the phosphodiester bond. So suppose there is a link, okay, one link and two link, and the bond is called as the phosphodiester bond. Now see, and one more thing, nitrogen is already present over here, so they will join with this one. Now see children, what is free, which part is free at this side? You all can see OH is free. Now what is the position of the OH? What is the carbon of the OH? The OH is present on the carbon number 3. So what we can write? We can write C3 or third prime. Okay. What we can write? We can write third prime is free here. Clear? Now come to the downside. Now here you see carbon number 5 containing phosphoric acid is free for getting attachment with another OH group. So this side is free. So what we can write down here? This is 5 prime. Okay. Now, if we draw this, then how we can draw? We can draw it like this. Which side is free? Here, this is 3rd prime. And here we can see the 5 prime is free. Now, I think so. It is better clear to you all. That is, these DNAs are anti-parallel to each other. If this side 5 prime is free, then this side it should be 3rd prime. And if this side is this 3rd prime is free, then this side it should be 5 prime free. Then only the structure of the DNA will be valid. Now, one more thing. These are the two lines of nucleotide, polymers of the nucleotide. Just to form the structure of DNA, they all have to join together. Okay. So how they will join? They will join with the help of hydrogen bond. Okay. Now this is called as hydrogen bond. Okay. So how many bonds are present in the structure of DNA? Answer will be 3. What are the 3 bonds? Number 1, glycosidic bond. What is the position of the glycosidic bond? It is in between the carbon number 1 and the nitrogen. In case of purines, it is in between the carbon number 1 and carbon number 9. And in case of pyrimidine, it will be in between carbon number 1 and the carbon number 1 of the nitrogen, that is pyrimidine. Okay. What is the next bond? The next bond is phosphodiester bond, and that is formed by the combination of the two nucleotides. Okay. And the third bond will be the hydrogen bond, which is present in between the two nitrogen bases. Clear? Now see children. If we see the structure of these nitrogen bases, and if we replace this N2 with any of the purine. Okay, now suppose in case of purine, I am writing A. So if it is replaced by A, then opposite of A will be thymine, that is present in the pyrimidine. Clear? So every time, purines paired with pyrimidines. And in case of purine, A always pairs with T. A always pairs with thymine along with the double bond of hydrogen bond. Okay, now come to the next purine. What is the next? Guanine. Okay, that is G. G always pair with cytosine of pyrimidine. And how they will join? They will join with the help of triple 3 hydrogen bonds. So this is triple bond. Okay, once again double bond. We can write down. Either you can write A or T. Any side, no issue. If this side is T, then this side will be A. Okay. So now you can see the structure of polymer of nucleotide, that they all are completely linked with one another. How they are linked? I have drawn one nucleotide, two nucleotide. This side I have linked all the nucleotides with the help of the phosphodiester bond, and this side I have linked all the nitrogen bases with the antiparallel structure of the same nucleotide along with the nitrogen bases, and this side I have joined them with the help of glycosidic bond, phosphodiester bond. Okay, now this will give us the basis of the structure of the DNA that was given by the Watson and Crick. Now the detailed structure we will see in the next part. Okay, thank you children.